الله.
Hey, hey, JF. Are you gonna get it? See if she want her juice.
She might just want her juice.
JL, can you get us some milk? Because she seemed to only want milk right now.
With Chesapeake Bay gleaming in the distance, we are inside M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Baltimore Ravens. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11. EA Sports. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The play fake. Crap. His throw incomplete. Well, look at this Baltimore defense against the pass. Just numbers that they haven't liked. Number 30 in the league right now.
You know, when actors get ready for a scene, they often ask the question, what's my motivation? But what's the motivation of this group? What's their mindset? What's the problem that they have? Will they create an identity that allows them to get better?
On third down, Pratt. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Breaks through the contact. Still on his feet. Inside the 10. Touchdown! With his ninth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Saints are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their 35-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. We'll get this to about the 38.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Again, they'll run. This is McGee. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45. A yard all they need, but it's third down. Jackson now. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have the Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Ravens at 2-7 now in the year. They have lost 3 straight here, and it kind of goes without saying, I guess, but they could certainly use a win.
Yeah, no doubt about that. There's a difference between a losing stretch and a losing streak, and right now, they're not playing their best football, but if they were to fall here, and now you're looking at going 4 games without a win, things can start compounding themselves pretty quickly from this point forward.
And he's got this down a yard or 2 shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that'll bring up second down. Here's McGee. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
And you look at the Saints defense. And they've shown the ability to play tough against the pass, currently ranked number 9 in the NFL.
This secondary has really developed into one of the strengths of this team. They diagnose, they cover, they run, they hit. What a nice team.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
I really like what he did there because he took his practice work and converted it to game action because he used his hands, got off the block, worked laterally and stayed to the outside, and finished off the runner for a loss.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown. And the last time out looking at Pete Franchise's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they're both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
To throw on second down. Crap. There's a short throw taken in by Bryan. 2 yards, good enough for first.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, he usually gets it done. Throwing on first down. Pratt. Complete. This is Mitchell. And they'll take him to the ground quickly. But he's able to get it down to the 41-yard line. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Play action. Pratt. And that's going to be incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Second and 10. Up the middle they go. Tyson, 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them to a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
To throw on third down, Pratt. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. They wind up losing three here.
Surprised that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
And this is gone from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. That was perfect. From distance, he steps up, knocks it right down Main Street.
And Main Street's celebrating right now with him, aren't they? I love the mechanics of the whole thing. Snap, hold, everything was right on target, and the blocking was perfect, and he executed so, so well.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Last time out, you remember, their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive...
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Saints are going to get possession of the football as time will run out on this first quarter of play. 10-3 our score after one here on EA Sports. A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. They'll start this drive out on the ground. He'll get it up near midfield or 49 before being taken down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Oh. Second down, Tyson. And it's a solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38. 87 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking in the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary. That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here.
What's happening? Seriously, is that a play?
That's a tie. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1 yard line. A good run, 8 yards there, and it'll be second and goal.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least 2, maybe 3 more shots from close range.
Second and goal from the 1. Now they'll switch it up here, look to throw. Rolling to his left, to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. This could very well be 4 down territory, but right now we focus on 3rd and goal from the 1. Looking to throw. Pratt eluding the pressure right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Kyle Hamilton picks it, and the Ravens are going to take over at their own 2-yard line. And the defense, Charles, they bit a little bit, but they did not break. And then on 3rd and goal there, the huge interception.
Think of the momentum they're carrying with them right now, Brandon, because in their mind, whether they want to admit it or not, they were conceding 3 points. Their goal was to keep them at the end zone, not give up a touchdown. Instead, they give up nothing. What a big-time play and a big-time stop by them.
After the interception, here's Jackson. He'll get this to Flowers, left side. Second down and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
To throw is Jackson. He finds his man. Complete. It's Reed. No gain there. It's going to bring up a 3rd down.
He steps out of bounds right at the line of scrimmage.
They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. This is McGee. He juked him, and he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Yet again, targeting and fighting Mark Andrews. And Andrews going to have a Ravens first down as the tackle made up around the 33-yard line. Now a dump off here complete. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. Our score 10-3 with 2 minutes remaining in quarter number 2. From the 41, here's second down and 2. Jackson will throw again. He finds his man complete. It's Phillips. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 42. 16 yards on that one by Raven first. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They go play action now. Jackson. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Here's second and 10. On the carry, McGee. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Second and a couple. He finds his man complete. It's Phillips. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down. On third and 1, Jackson. And he is caught. And the Ravens are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on third and 1. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They go play action with Jackson. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. Touchdown! A great play there with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Ravens go 98 yards and finish it off in the end zone. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets hurt sometimes? The back of the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself. You don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
Now a second and 10. Throwing again. Pratt. He's got a man complete. And he would work work his way out of bounds here at the 25-yard line. A big play there just before halftime. 58 yards.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, only they were all this easy because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball.
And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Now a timeout taken. That's a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout. If they hurry, we'll see. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Back to throw. Crap. He finds his man complete. That's Franklin. Down the right sideline. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Saints have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes it a 17-10 score. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. And he finally goes out of bounds, so he couldn't take it the distance, but all the way inside the 15. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number 3 here. One touchdown is the difference. 17-10 our score, and we are back underway on EA Sports. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Now Jackson on second down. But that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. Pass the field. The players out of bounds. It's a game of try and picking up the first.
Good job there getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
He finds his man complete. That's Phillips. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight. It's a 45-yard line. Jackson. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two short of the 40. The Raven passing game getting in sync on the first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Jackson. And
this one's incomplete. He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Phillips. Now this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 28. The drive stays intact with a pickup of 13. They'll run with McGee. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Here's Jackson. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Reed. And in for the Ravens touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Ravens are an extra point away from evening this one up. Certainly there are good things about quick strike offenses that score fast, but a long drive can also work to your advantage as well.
In so many ways, Brandon, because number one, you get them tired, but the big one is mentally. They can't figure out how to slow you down, how to get off the field, how to get the ball back. They go to the bench wondering, what are we going to do next time in order to stop those guys?
Tucker able to connect on the extra point. That will level the playing field at 17-all. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. After that last touchdown we just saw, Charles, we got ourselves a brand new ball game, all tied here in the third as they have their first possession of this second half.
And Brandon, this drive is all about one word to me, and that's the word answer, because they're trying to answer the momentum the other offense picked up in tying the game, because not only if they score and they feel better about themselves, they'll retake the lead and maybe set the tone for the rest of the half, keeping them in the driver's seat. On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
On third down, Pratt. He's got his target. That's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards. On first down, Pratt again to Bryant, and again it's caught. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. Second down. But looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Looking to throw on second down. Pratt. Now he'll escape to his right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Multiple players getting home there, and it's a loss of 2 on the sack. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Got a man here. It's Brown. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 31-yard line. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 down at the 31. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about 4, second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winging in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
to throw on second down. Crack. And his throw's going to be incomplete. With that matchup, the adjustment that was made, you have a blazing guy on a blazing guy, and defensively, he won that battle.
The closing speed is the key. When you have a guy that fast and he can close at the end of a play and knock it away, that's a big deal. We just saw him do it right there.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Mitchell. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Here's a give up the middle, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time... They've been in the red zone three times in this game and have not scored a single point. Can they break through here on second and goal? Closer, he's down to about the two.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one that was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Off the play fake, crack. And he's got him, it's caught in the end zone, touchdown New Orleans. Patrick Ricard, his first touchdown on the year. And the Saints answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. The extra point up and good. And they will take a 7-point lead. The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team booms it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Devin Duvernay. He's inside the 20. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Ravens.
One of the most exciting plays in football. A kickoff return for a touchdown. And in all the excitement, let's not lose sight of the fact that now the pressure shifts to that snapper, holder, and kicker. This extra point is really important.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. And no sweat. He puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter. And a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. And he'll be out right at the 35. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. They'll try the left side. Tyson. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up.
And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Saints. Travis Kelce, 61 yards. And the Saints strike quickly to take the lead here in the fourth. Point after, right down the middle. And they will take a 7-point lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Ravens take over first down at their own 22-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, they've had success getting the ball to him out of the backfield, but this time they had a man right on it. He was able to break that play up before he could get started.
Jackson now on second and 10. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins.
And into a sea of defenders and intercepted. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Down Tyson, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where I'm covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A gain there of 21 yards.
This is one of those plays that has an equal chance of either being a big gain or a big loss. But with the college influence, we're seeing more of these plays come into the NFL.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to the receiver. But he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Ball resting on the 10-yard line. It's second and 1. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the Saints are going to have a first and goal as some good running there gets them down to about the 2-yard line, knocking on the door.
And that's the type of run that they're looking for, because they'll need to continue to rely on them to move the sticks in this tight game in order to preserve this lead.
Now they'll change things around before the snap. In motion left is Mitchell. He's going to handle it on the touch pass. And he'll score! Touchdown, New Orleans! A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints might be moving closer to an elusive second win of the year as they extend that fourth quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead now up to 14. The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team booms it away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. This is first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first time out. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Here's second down. Jackson. They're looking deep here for Flowers. And got his man complete. Raven football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Jackson on first down. And that is caught, but he will come down out of bounds, says the sign judge, incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Down at the two. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. Here's a handoff out of the gun. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame woofing has turned into results.
Will the defense pressure or sit back? Here's fourth and five. Here we go. It's Jackson on fourth down. And he's got it. Touchdown. A great play there. With his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Ravens have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side. Get that high hop and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
On the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And the Saints hands team able to rein this one in. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee.